Hi Blender users. Today we're going to create a pyramid out of geometry nodes. This is going to let us control the age and degradation of the pyramid. First, add in a grid and set it to 50 by 100 subdivisions. Go into edit mode, take the knife tool and slice diagonally along the grid. In face select mode, go to the top left corner, select that face, go to the bottom right corner and control select. Delete those faces, then select the island here and delete that too. Staying in edit mode, select the triangle here, move it over so that the left side lines up with the object origin point. In the modifiers tab, add a mirror. Enable clipping and then apply it. Next, open up a geometry nodes window. Give the side of the pyramid a proper name. Next, we have to create our brick object. So add in a cube, bring it into edit mode, bring down the scale, and then make it wider. Add in a plane, and we're going to use that to instance the side of the pyramid 4 times, one for each vertice. And then give it its own geometry node tree. Move the plane to its own collection. And then we're going to add another collection, and we're going to move the bricks there. Add in a point instance geometry node, and then use the selector and select the pyramid side object. Next, we're going to add align rotation to vector. We need to change it from vector to attribute and make this position. And it wasn't working here because I had to add the align rotation before the point instance node. In edit mode, just rotate it into position and then adjust the scale of the plane and line up those tips just right. Scale it some more so that the edges don't overlap each other. It should be perfect. On our pyramid side object, we're going to add in a new geometry node tree, and we're going to name it pyramid side. Add in a point instance node and select the brick. Right now it's looking a little too big, and you could adjust that in edit mode, but I think it'd be better if we just use geometry nodes. We would have a lot more control that way. Add an attribute math node, set A to scale, change B to a float, and the result should also be scale. And we're gonna adjust this later, but this is just for a quick sizing of the bricks. So we're gonna come back to this. Add in an attribute randomize node. We're gonna use this to align the brick's rotation with the slope, and we're gonna use it to add a little bit of variation in the rotation of each brick. This gives it kind of a more tangible, realistic feeling. And then I'm just going to go into side mode and adjust these so they line up. Add in an attribute sample texture node. We're going to use this to control the decay of the bricks. Now go into edit mode and then unwrap and project from view. We're doing this because it's going to be mapped using this UV map here. You got to plug it into this field here. And then set the result to scale. And you should probably name this node because you're going to be going back and forth a lot between them when you want to adjust the decay. Add in a clouds texture, and now you can see that the texture is affecting the scale. And if you want to adjust this, you just change the brightness or the contrast value here. Next, we're going to delete this attribute math node, and then we're going to replace it with an attribute clamp node. We're going to use this because we don't want the bricks to be scaled infinitely. We want them to stop at a certain size. Okay, now add in another attribute math node. Change it to multiply, set A to scale, make B a float, and set this to a really high number, and then add scale as the result. You also need to add scale into the attribute and result field on the clamp node. What's happening here is that the multiply node is basically acting as a contrast boost so that the values will either be 0 or 0.1 with no in between. And that's what I want because I want the bricks to just pop into existence. And then change the attribute clamp to a vector, and then adjust the size of the bricks so that it fills in the area, but leave just a small gap in between them. Now I want to show you how to have a different object for the corners. With the side of the pyramid selected, we're going to create 3 vertex groups called inner, left, and right. Next, go into the modifiers tab and shut off the geometry nodes modifier. Select the bottom right vertice and control select the edge, but don't select the top vertice. assign that to the right group, do the same for the left side, select all of them, and then deselect the left and the right side, and then go into here and remove the top vertice and assign that to inner. I'm going to make some room, and then I'm going to change scale here to decay, and that's going to create a new attribute called decay. Add in an attribute math, subtract, put in the decay attribute we just made, put in left for B, and then the result is going to be scale. Now we're subtracting bricks from the left side here. Change scale to inner decay, and that's going to create a new attribute called inner decay. Duplicate this math node, and we're going to keep it as subtract, and we're going to add inner decay as A, and set B to right, and the result is scale. Now we're subtracting from both sides of the pyramid. Duplicate the brick object and call it brick side. Select these nodes in the group here and create a new frame. Our node tree is about to get a lot bigger, so this is going to be useful for keeping track of everything. Name it to inner bricks and duplicate that. Name it left bricks, duplicate it again, and name it right bricks. And then connect these all up. Now I'm removing the point instance objects from left and right, and I'm going to assign them to this new side brick object. So we're going to use the same method as the inner brick portion, but instead of subtracting the left and right side, we're going to be subtracting the inner and right side. Plug that in, and you should see that it's just one row of bricks, and this is just the left side. So do the same for the right bricks, and then you're going to subtract inner, and you're going to subtract left, and it should leave you just the right side. And when you join all three up, it now fills in every vertex group with a brick. Select the side brick object, add in a Boolean modifier, and we're going to use this to control the angle cut of the brick on each side of the pyramid. I'm also going to change the visibility to wire so that it's easier to work with. And we need to adjust the scale of the brick on the right, otherwise it's backwards. So just put a negative value in the scale there and it should flip. Select your Boolean and then go to a close-up view of the side of the pyramid. And here you should be able to adjust the scale, the rotation, and the location of this Boolean to get the perfect angle that you want. Originally, I tried applying the Boolean to this final object here, but the performance is just so much better if you apply it to a single instance of the brick instead. As you can see that there's a little bit of intersection between these bricks here. So go into edit mode for the pyramid side object and scale it down a little just on one axis. And then select the Boolean object on the side brick and move that over until it all just lines up. We also have to fix the top here. On the pyramid side object, we need to select this top vertex and remove it from every vertex group. Then we need to create a new vertex group. I'm going to call it top and assign it to it. Duplicate the Boolean and the side brick together, and this will be our new top brick. Select this frame here, and we're going to duplicate all the nodes in it, bring it down, name it top bricks, connect it up. And now we have to do the same method as before, except we need to subtract all the vertex groups from the top vertex group. And by doing that, we need to add an additional math node. Plug that into the geometry and give it a preview. It's missing because I ended up typing scale in with a capital. It is case sensitive. We can see the bricks on its own when it's isolated with the top vertex group. But if we select these, we can see that there's still a brick at the top portion. So we need to add another subtraction math node here. And we need to remove the top vertex group from all these other groups. Join them all together using the join geometry node, and let's see how it worked out. First, we need to make sure we had the right object selected for the top and assign it the top brick. Second, we need to scale this top brick so that it's wider than the top of the pyramid just by a little bit. Adjust the position of the Boolean. I'm going to mirror the Boolean object, and then I'm going to bring up this top face until they all converge at the very top. And then I'm going to do some final adjustments here and connect them both, so to cut off the top piece. There you go. Because we added this randomized rotation node at the front of the chain, we can adjust every group at the same time and add a little bit of variation in the rotation of these bricks. And if you go into the texture panel now and adjust the brightness of the image texture, you can see how it removes the bricks where it gets dark. I'm actually going to change this to a marble texture because I like the look a lot better. And if you go into the UV edit mode, you can adjust the scale and rotation, and that will adjust the direction of these lines. So we're going to take all these nodes except for the input and output and duplicate them and move them down. Take the first group of nodes and Control G, put them in a group of their own. The reason we duplicated all these nodes is because we're going to use it as the middle layer of the pyramid. And once we add a transform node in there, it'll be really easy to move the entire thing at once. I'm now resetting all the bricks rotation to zero so that we can have a staircase layout instead of a slope. We want to adjust the scale again to make sure there's no gap between the bricks. And you're going to want to do that with the left, right, and top vertex groups. Now we need to remove this attribute sample texture and add a new one in so we can control this layer independently from the other. We have to change decay to a new attribute so we can have independent control of this layer of bricks. You have to go into every frame here and also change the attribute in all of them. I'm going to switch this around so that the middle layer has a marble texture and the outer layer has a clouds texture. Now select all of this and add them to their own group. Rename it and then add a join geometry node and connect it up. Now you should be seeing both layers of bricks here. Add in a transform node and move that middle layer inwards. Just like we did on the upper layer, we're going to go in and make sure there's a little bit of randomization on the rotation here. I need to duplicate the brick collection so that each layer of the pyramid has its own collection assigned to it. Doing this allows us to apply different materials to each layer of the pyramid. The innermost layer of the pyramid is only going to need one brick, so I'll delete the other two. To create the most inner portion of the pyramid, we're going to use a different method. Add in a cube, merge the top vertices so it's a pyramid, and bring it down and scale it so it's just slightly smaller than the outer layer. We're going to give this object its own geometry nodes tree, and we're going to add a point distribute node and a point instance node. I want this layer just to look like a massive pile of rocks. Add in an attribute randomization, set it to scale, set it to vector, adjust the sizing so that there's some variation between them. I want this to look like a pile of rocks. Next, duplicate that attribute random node and change it from scale to rotation, and then rotate it only on the z-axis until it's completely random. And then adjust the density so it's completely filled in and you can't see through the pyramid. You might need to make some minor adjustments like I did so that everything just lines up perfectly. Alright, that's it. We are finished the geometry nodes portion of this and we can move on to texturing now. On our brick material, bring in an image texture and plug that into the base color. We're going to unwrap each side of the brick using projection unwrapping, and we're going to scale the brick down to be the size of a brick in the image. For the square sides, I'm going to line it up with this square brick here in this image texture I'm using. I'm only going to use one brick for this tutorial, but if you had a collection of bricks, you could use that instead. Now add a displacement node, plug in your image in there, and then adjust it till it's right. Then select the other bricks in the collection and link the materials to the first brick. Now we're going to add some random variations in the color for each brick. Add in a mixed color node, make it dark brown, and set it to multiply. Next, add in a object info node and use the random value and plug it into the factor. Next, add two math nodes. Set the second one to multiply and the first to add. The multiply one will be basically the contrast, and the add will just adjust the brightness. Now for the outer layer of the pyramid, we're going to start off with the same material, but then we're going to unlink it to create a new material. Name it white bricks. And then change the brown color to white and change it to add. Duplicate that principal shader. We're going to put the metallic to 100. We're going to change it to a gold color and bring the roughness down. Now add in a mixed shader node, and we're going to control the factor by using a geometry input node and setting it to position. Add in a color ramp and set that to constant, and this will give you a hard line instead of a gradient. Next, add a separate XYZ node and plug the z-axis into the factor. And then add a math node after that. And now you can adjust the height of the gold shader by using either the color ramp or the add node. All that's left is to give materials to this base layer. Copy the material from the middle layer of bricks, make it its own instance, and darken it. And that's it. Now you have a pyramid you can control the age of using just a couple of sliders on these image textures. In part two of this tutorial, we're going to add this pyramid to a larger time-lapse scene that I hope is going to show an extreme amount of time compressed down into just a few seconds. Thanks for watching. Remember to like and subscribe for more.